And all citizens of Hawaii. Today we celebrate our 1,000th telecast, and in honor of this occasion have decided to deviate from our regular program format and honor the gentleman responsible for its beginning and longevity, its host producer Bob Barker, with a surprise roast. With the exception of few, most of our participants are not celebrities, but merely cool hearts, and through the magic of friendship and esteem for Bob, have agreed to be on the program. The show will also include outs of film clips, which Bob thinks were left on the cutting room floor. Please enjoy as we present Paʻahana Years 1000.
Fella, you're a little late. Would you please take your seat over here, sir? You're a little late. Would you take your seat over here? Oh, the other side. Would you sit over here, sir? I'm sorry. I'm a little confused. And look at Bob. He's trying to remember. You're trying to remember why you're here, right?
I'm trying to figure
it's a
out
roast,
what's going
Bob.
On.
No, you don't talk. I do all the talking today. You just listen. Okay?
Yellow.
life was so tender that dreams were kept beside your pillow. Try to remember when life was so tender that love was an ember about to billow. Try to remember, and if you remember, then follow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember, although you know the snow.
Look at Bob trying to remember. I'm just trying to caution you again, you're here for a roast, Bob. Now, our first guest is a staff specialist at the Technical Assistance Center, or in this case, the Department of Education's answer to Dean Martin's friend, Shirley Winters. Ladies and gentlemen, Mrs. Camille Almy.
Thank you, Sterling. The Technical Assistance Center of the Department of Education has a video cassette loan library, and we have copies of many programs from various television stations that we loan to teachers and librarians all over the state. One of the most favoritest programs is Pauhana Years. And Bob, it never fails. Every time we loan a copy, we're swamped with requests for your thoughts at the end of the program. And when I was first asked about this, you know, I didn't think we could print any of his thoughts. But do you realize that people believe that you have thought up all of these thousand thoughts that have finished the ends of the program? Now, we hated to tell everybody, but we thought we could just tell your friends that this is what he really uses, the International Dictionary of Thoughts. This is his own private copy, but he's pretty much run out. He doesn't have much left. We're going to give this back to him, but we have a special copy. It's kind of small. It's the Revised Dictionary of New Thoughts. And we thought that he could use this for his next 1,000 programs. Bob, this is just for you.
Thank you, Camille. You walked off on the wrong side. Our next guest evidently read his invitation wrong. He thought this was a toast instead of a roast. The coordinator for senior and cultural affairs for the Parks and Recreation, a man who started with Pauhana Years, Chris Nakama.
Today marks the 1,000th anniversary show of Pauhana Years. This year is the 200th birthday of our United States of America. When the Pauhana Years was established over a decade ago, we only had a handful of senior citizen clubs. At the present time, there are over 80 such clubs from Hawaii Kai to Wailua and from Kahuku to Waimanalo. Through the efforts of Bob Barker, many of the clubs and its members have been featured in Pauhana Years programs. Among the many professionals, who have been responsible for elevating the status and roles of our senior citizens from a negative to a positive one, none stand taller than Bob Barker of Pawhana Years. Bob and Pawhana Years have been very successful in changing the attitude of the general public concerning senior citizens from that of weak, listless, senile persons to vigorous, energetic, and helpful community participants. Bob and his deep insight, empathy, understanding of the needs and aspiration of senior citizens have made Pawhana Years a warm, rich, down-to-earth family picture program depicting the trials, tribulations, and exhilaration of the process of growing old graciously. I would like to conclude this toast to host Barker by reciting a poem by Lillian Dorion entitled Eyes of the Beholder. I haven't lost the bloom of youth. The eyes still have a twinkle. My skin is smooth, but here and there, my mirror has a wrinkle. And that's power. Thank you.
Yeah, that's pretty good, Chris.
You're full of wind, don't
I think we better doctor this roast up. Okay. We're going to introduce our next speaker. She's the director of Hawaii Public Television, Dr. Mary Bitterman.
Thank you, Sterling. I have just a brief remark and something of a personal nature. The first time my 5-year-old daughter visited the station, she saw a white-bearded man approaching her in the hallway, and she screamed with delight, "That's Bob Barker. I see him all the time on Pawhana Years." I was surprised, of course, since I think of her as being with the Sesame Street and Electric Company crowd. But I think perhaps this is one of the great things you've done, Bob, is to bridge the generation gap, to make Pawhana Years as exciting for the Sesame Street and Electric Company crowd as for some of our older citizens. May you have another 1,000 programs featuring you, and may you continue to attract interested and excited viewers from the ages of 5 to 105 plus.
Thank you, Dr. Bitterman. I know you made the kid watch his program, don't tell me. I transition to another type of doctor, the Pawhana crew, and especially their producer, labor over another difficult but impossible, not impossible, task.
He's been in labor for some time. I think we better.
What's the EKG found on this patient, nurse?
What is it? EKG?
What's
the
EKG?
Echo EKG? What is the count on?
I think you damn fools are getting serious.
Under my ass. That is the
ball. Okay.
Help, somebody help me.
Well,
yeah,
she's
mowing
a lot
of labor.
If it's going down,
she's in
stress, and we better do something.
I feel a lot of hot air.
You keep pushing, and you're
going to
get
hot.
What's happening?
Help. Help. Help.
I think she's in a vacuum.
She's taking this to
you. Let me have a razor. Let me have the razor.
Oh, they're getting serious.
It's gotta be sterile.
Oh, man.
Hey,
Doctor. Scalpel. Scalpel. Oh, be careful with that. Oh, that's terrible.
Oh, the baby.
Scissors.
Oh, Doctor.
You should
just rip it.
I think I feel something here. Here it is.
Oh, congratulations. What is that, Doctor?
Oh, it's
Barker.
Looks just like you.
Oh, yes, my little baby.
Oh,
I haven't laughed so hard in so long.
Is anybody going to help him up or what? Yeah, you got to leave that thing.
Am I still tied down someplace?
You know, that's why the doctors wear those things, you know.
We'll let you down.
So nobody will recognize him.
Oh, you are a good patient.
A man who should have been a doctor, because he's so very detailed in his work, the administrator of educational television, Bob Donegan.
As Bob's immediate boss, I'm required once every year to evaluate his job performance. And it's interesting to look back in the file at the remarks made on the evaluations by some of my predecessors. In 1968 and 1969, it was said that he needed to relax more in front of the TV camera and to project more casual image than he did before that. He must have taken that advice very much to heart, because today if Bob Barker had a casual contest with, say, Perry Como, I think the camera person would go to sleep. By 1970, he evidently had that problem licked, and so he was told the next couple of years to experiment more, to try more imaginative approaches in the program format. That must have been all the excuse he needed, because we've been paying for plane tickets and rental cars and hotel rooms ever since. The next year, he even went to Japan for several programs. But we at the Department of Education are very proud of Bob and of his program, which is the most watched adult public television program in Hawaii. And when you compare that and can beat the likes of Masterpiece Theater and Jenny and a lot of the other good things that public television sends our way, that's indeed something to celebrate. Congratulations, Bob.
Thank you, Bob. We're still trying to get off the ground. And Bob, speaking of off the ground, a couple of friends of yours stopped by earlier, and I want to show you something.
Bob Barker, this is Big Bird, and I discovered we have something in common. We both do bird shows. I mean, Sesame Street has me. It doesn't have turkeys. But you have nothing but turkeys. And that's the truth.
Hi, wait.
This is incredible.
You're the crew chief. What are all these feathers doing here?
Feathers? These feathers?
Yeah.
These are turkey feathers, John.
From what?
Pauhana years, John. This is the biggest turkey that ever hit.
What's a turkey?
A turkey is a large bird that never gets off the ground. And in 999 shows, they still haven't gotten off the ground yet.
Gee, that is really incredible. That happens after every...
Frank!
Frank, what? Frank, do you have to do this after every show?
Oh, my goodness.
Do you have to do this?
Lord, I didn't
Frank.
Get him.
You got some more.
Frank,
I didn't get him, but I got the feathers.
Do you have to do this after every show?
No.
Good. Huh? Do you have to do this after every show?
Well, yeah, mostly every time. Sometimes there are more, sometimes there are less.
That's incredible.
All depends on the molting season.
You guys have about enough here for a pillow.
And that's the truth.
Well, while we're still on the ground, let's call the crew chief of this whole mess, Wade Covion.
Well, Bob, on behalf of all the production crews, past and present, that have worked on Pauhana Years, we're going to give you an itemized bill. 42 cans of Spray-Doll used in shining up or de-shining that bald head every time we have to backlight it. 18 ashtrays that mysteriously disappear from the studio every time we tape. 6 cases of Geritol from the crew's personal stock. 21 bottles of oxygen just to get them up there. And 7 cases of no-dos that the crew has to take just to do the show. We don't want you to think that the crew hasn't gotten anything out of the show. We're sure that on the crew there's at least one or two people that have. They haven't admitted it, but there may be. Yeah. Okay. Bob, you may not be an old turkey, but I'll tell you one thing. You're definitely a wild turkey.
The man who was here when it began. The former producer, associate producer of Power Hunter Years, Mr. Chet Brower.
Thank you, Shirley. There you are.
You know, I'm not going to read this. You know, when I first applied for the job as associate producer of Power Hunter Years, way back in 1966 from Jim Levine and Don Wood, and they said they have a year's grant for the show, I thought, my gosh, what are we going to do for a full year with senior citizens? Well, after the first year, it took Bob a whole year to say, welcome to the program for and by the senior citizens of Hawaii. I figured he had it made for as long as he wanted, and here's 1,000 programs. Well, I could only wait till 850. I had to leave, but congratulations.
Pretty good. Somebody should fix my chair with it. Every time I sit down, it cracks, it creaks, like some bones around here. Now our next guest goes back as far back as the beginning. Also, I'm speaking on behalf of the Parks and Recreation Senior Citizens Group. That is, if you don't wing the Wong number, Mrs. Ni Chang Wong.
Bob Barker, you are a great guy, but you only show our backsides when Harry and I stroll off at the end of some of the Power show. You are our thoughtful friend and a great morale builder. You have made everyone appreciate all our senior citizens and their contributions in building Hawaii'i. Bob Barker, we also thank you for always leaving everyone with this thought. Don't laugh at old age. Just pray to reach it graciously and in good health.
I don't know, Mrs. Wong, this program has turned into a praise instead of a roast. Watch it! A beautiful senior citizen, the grand dame or queen of entertainment, and the first guest of Power Hunter Years, the one and only Hilo Hattie. Yeah.
Thank you, Sterling.
See, Hawaiians, we kiss.
Yeah, kiss, kiss, kiss. All-time kiss. You know, when I was invited to take part on this program to roast my dear friend, Bob Barker, I couldn't come up with anything to rib him about. I could only picture Bob as a chef with a tall white hat and a number one choice of a big standing rib roast. From this, Bob has always been ready to produce for and by senior citizens like me on Pau Hana Years some very delightful, tasty choice cuts of entertainment. Rare, medium, well done, or a crisp, crunchy, juicy outside cut. Even a rib to chew on. However you like it, it was always ever so uno. Bob, mahalo for all these years that you've spent on our senior citizen shows. And just keep cooking with our growing membership of Pau Hana Years senior citizens.
Well, that was grand, Hilo. I mean, you said some of the right things about Bob. Now, a queen should be followed by a king. And the administrative assistant of Hawaii Public Television, Mike King.
As a former student of working on Hawaii
for Hawaii Public Television and on the Pioneers program. I can recall many years ago, first starting at the station and the Pioneers project and how many shows we worked on, and that the many opportunities it provided for, I would say, probably hundreds of students who've worked in the station through the years, the opportunity to, you know, work on lighting and sets and putting up logos such as this big one back here. But I think one of the most important things that it provided us beyond the more technical aspects was something a little more difficult to get a feel on, and that is a sense of professionalism, which Bob demonstrated to us day after day, show after show. That I think that's what I think the most important thing that we carried away from Pioneers and Bob Barker.
Charlotte, this show is going downhill. You know, there's a saying that you can always judge a person by the painting in his home. Well, let's take a look at the walls in Bob's home. And it was Bob who said, a man who has pictures of himself is egotistical. Bob, what I want to know is how long did it take to take those pictures of yourself? I'm talking about pictures, Bob. You know, a few years ago, the Power Hunter crew went to Japan, and Bob has been asking the guys for some pictures that were taken while he was out there, they could never find. We don't know the ones he's asking about, but your Japanese translator, Huwa Tateishi, insisted they were. So, Huwa Tateishi.
You may not have known this, but Bob Barker is an egotist of a sort. He likes to be the center of an attraction all the time. For instance, when we went to Japan for the Papua New Year's coverage of the activities of the senior citizens in Japan, Bob always managed to be the center of attention. Bob was able to convince the barmaids in Kyoto and the geisha girls in Tokyo, as the picture may show you later, that he was a fabulously wealthy plantation owner in Hawaii. And all the pretty wahines believed him. Of course, some thought he was more likely Santa Claus-san because of his beard. Oh yes, he was very pleased and flattered when those nice ladies kept referring to him as Baka-san, Baka-san. Bob, of course, had no way of knowing that in Japanese, baka means stupid, foolish, imbecile, feeble-minded, and so forth. As you saw in the group picture taken before the Tokyo Tower, our group all followed the Japanese custom of wearing gauze masks to prevent any of our honorable germs from spreading to our hosts in Japan. You will notice that only Bob Barker-san didn't wear one. He didn't want to ruin his handsome, attractive, respectable appearance with a lowly mask. I have one of those masks, and I'd like to assure Bob that wearing it will definitely not detract from his unquestionable good look.
It'll keep the lid on things for a while. Now we're getting down to brass tacks. I like that, Hoover, the way you did that. It's very nice. The chairperson of the Commission on Aging, Mrs. Shim Kanazawa.
Bob Barker has been a household word with our seniors. He has been entertaining them through the tube for a good many years. On March 7th, 1966, a demonstration project in ETV programming began for the elderly throughout the state. It was agreed at that time that if successful, the program would hopefully be continued in future years. As you can see, it has been a tremendous success and has continued without interruption for 10 years. The Commission on Aging also initiated funding for the simulcast and translation in Japanese on October 1st, 1969. On behalf of all the kupuna of the state of Hawaii, I thank Bob for providing the kupuna with informative service, instructional, and other worthwhile citizenship and cultural opportunities. We'd like to also wish you success in your continuance of Paohana years for at least another decade and more. Thank you.
The Paohana years program, Bob, are you still awake? Okay. Anyway, speaking of programming, our next guest is KHET's programming assistant, Lucinda Travis.
When Charlotte said this was a roast, I took him seriously. I just love roast because it gives you the opportunity to be completely honest. And that's exactly what I want to be, Bob, is honest. My programming department have been the fall guys for you long enough. Every time a wrong program gets on the air or a wrong listing gets in the TV guide, it's always our fault. And that's not the truth. What really happens is that 5 minutes before airtime, he's still working on the program, and I'm going, Bob, Bob, hurry up, I need the show. And he's going, wait, wait, I haven't got it finished yet. Consequently, we have to air another program, and it looks like to the public that we've made a mistake. But it's not really our mistake, it's his, and that's the truth. I'm not getting married.
Well, now we're getting somewhere with this program.
Send them in.
Roast. I like that.
Pizza for Bob Baker. Pizza for Bob Baker. With the whole works on it. Hey, hey, the whole works. Bob hey. Baker, you...
No, 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 no. We're doing a television show.
Huh? Yeah.
Who do you want?
Bob Baker.
Martin. I'm Sterling Marsden. Who do you want?
Are you Bob Baker?
No. I'm Sterling Marsden. Wait, you get anything that...
Bob Barker.
Oh, Barker, yeah, well, that's the guy.
Oh, you Bob Barker. That'll be $3.72. $3.72.
But where'd that come from, bro?
Pizza Hut across the street, just across the way.
Yeah, but not enough for everybody over here.
Hey, just try cut them in 1,000 pieces.
You like get lost in a while because, okay. You know, I don't know.
Congratulations from the Pizza Hut manager where our people make out better. Oh, wait, I mean make it better.
Bob, our next guest is a young upcoming director at this station who thinks you're a great guy but very dull. Paul Swanson.
Oh, yeah. Try to remember. Every Tuesday and Thursday, that song echoes down the halls. Try to remember. Well, last night I tried to remember what Bob had on his last show, and I couldn't. It's so dull, Bob. The crew falls asleep, the director's hanging in the control room, the engineers are fast asleep. The only reason it's the most popular program with senior citizens is because it's the only time they can get 30 minutes of straight sleep. And Bob Barker's hair didn't fall out. He got up and left. I remember when Charlotte Simmons, the associate producer, first came here and was being interviewed by Bob and many others. Bob got her aside and says, hey, where you been hiding all my life? And she says, well, for the first half, I wasn't born yet. See, Charlotte and Bob share offices, and it's really cute. Every once in a while, like Wade was saying earlier, you know, you open Charlotte's desk drawer, and there's a little bottle of Kahlua in there, you know. Go over on the other side, and Bob opens his drawer, and it's a giant economy-sized Geritol. Says he can't make it through the show without it, half a pint at a time, you know? But you see, Bob has this problem. You see, anytime he steps outside the building, 30 little Cub Scouts grab him and carry him across the nearest intersection. Last week, he made it all the way out to Mililani Town before they finally ran out of Scouts. And that was just after his bus pass expired, too. It seems he had a fight with this little old lady for a seat on the bus, and he said it would have been a fair fight if she hadn't hit him with her crutch. Well, anyways, Bob, I'd just like to say this is Paul Swanson leaving you with this thought. I don't know if anybody who has contributed more to the people of Hawaii than you have. I don't think it can even be measured, let alone repaid, and I just want to say congratulations and thank you.
You started out well, Paul, and you went downhill after that. Yeah, I'm way all ahead of my script right now. I tell you that much because I get well.
You're on page 9.
I'm on page 9. Hey, kind of sit up, Bob. We got a long way to go yet. If our next guest didn't use his imagination, who knows what some of the Pauhana programs have been like? The photographer of Pauhana years, for the past 10 years, Joe Kono.
Bob, anybody who can bring me in front of a camera is a great producer. I hope your title doesn't change to associate producer after this show today.
Hi. Hey, Joe.
How you doing?
Not bad.
Not bad. How long have you been working on the Pauhana show?
10 years.
10 years.
10 years too much. I feel like a senior citizen, you know,
yeah?
Working for that show.
Does that show do it to you?
Yeah, it sure does.
Yeah, hey, you are the cinematographer, right? You take all the pictures.
Right, I do.
You make many outer island trips?
Oh, I think I made about 60 trips total for that station.
Yeah.
More than half of 500 years. We do a lot of traveling to outer islands mostly.
Listen, how is it working with Bob Barker? I've heard a lot of stories.
Oh, he's all right.
He's okay.
But when we go to outer island, you know, I have to do a lot of work. And I should be the boss, but
what?
I have to carry half of the substitute.
What does the director do?
Director, ex-maker director. I got Charlotte Simmons, the associate producer. She's so petite, you know, and so feminine, like, never helps carry. I would have my wife carry that camera equipment for me, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. And if Bob always act like a big producer, he never helps carry, you know? Yeah.
I've heard with the
director. Uh-huh. The associate producer while we're doing all the carrying. He always make a set 4 or 5 different times before he makes up his mind what he want to do. You know? And that's a lot of work for nothing.
How has the show been treating you? How are you living? You got a nice place?
Well, I worked for 110 years. At least I had a down payment for a little shack, you know?
That's really nice. You go there regularly, huh?
Regularly, right.
Yeah.
But you asked me about other island.
Yeah.
I like to work in Honolulu, you know.
Uh-huh.
People figure when I go to the other island, I go on a vacation.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, when you go to other island, you have to take everything with you.
Yeah,
and usually we get 20 cases. And the funny thing is, when we go to the other island, go to a hotel,
mm-hmm.
it's always happened. The last room from the hotel is our room.
Uh-huh.
So we have to carry everything in the hotel. You know, I got a back problem, you know, with carrying back and forth from the hotel to the car, from the car to the site, from the site back to the car, from the car back to the hotel, from the hotel up to the...
Boy.
And usually what they do is they give us the last room.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean? Parking lot is here, our room is here. That means you have to carry all your equipment there, carry all the equipment back.
Yeah.
You know, we stay there usually our trip takes 5 days. That means 5 days of shooting on other islands.
Yeah. Thanks, Joe. Thanks for talking to me. Okay.
10 years. 10 years too much. About 2 weeks ago, Bob Barker called Charlotte and spoke to her. I told Charlotte that sometime when you talk to me, Charlotte, I think you're lying to me. And Bob would wish that Charlotte would do more work around here. Actually, what Charlotte was doing all this behind his back. She was putting in about 12 to 14 hours a day. Not only days, but we used to work nights too. Next guest speaker here. Bob's done a lot to the, done a lot. This is an association of retired persons. So now they sent their president to get back at him. So Mrs. Bella Argento. Hey.
You almost made it. It's Argentiano. I'm always correcting people, so call me Bella. Humor is not my forte, as I'm always serious. As my husband Sam says, I'm very English. I find myself unable to be humorous. Of course, when this roast is over, I will think of plenty of witty things I could have said. I do want to thank Bob for his wonderful insight about older persons, his calmness, and the ability he has of drawing thoughts out of those on his programs, and the beauty of the finished production about our elders, which gives the viewing audience a picture of our peers. It is comforting to know that we have such a discerning and creative person among us. Bob, I love you.
Thank you very much. Most television personalities have their gimmicks, and we're wondering what Bob's is. But the next guest is wondering what he's doing in television. KHET's Development and Promotional Manager, Cliff Eblen.
Well, the first time I saw Bob Barker on television, he was doing the news on Channel 9, and I knew at a glance I was watching a first-rate newsman, a real talent who really belonged in radio. What he's doing on television, I've never figured out, really. It's been interesting, however, during the past 10 years to watch him grow and develop. Until now, he really looks right for the part. He would still make a heck of a good radio announcer.
You know, look at Bob being roasted when I know he'd rather be sauced. Now, Bob's saucing partner, when they go on neighbor island trips, the audio technician, you know who that is? Wendell Peacock.
I know I was invited to this roast of badmouth Bob Barker, and I just can't bring myself to do it. Bob has done more for our senior citizenry than Geritol and anybody else. Bob's a gentleman. I've seen him open a door for a woman who was carrying a load of groceries, and there's absolutely no rumor to the fact that he tripped her as she went by. He's generous to a fault. When we're going these outer island trips, he shares his cigarettes and his bourbon with me, right? At retail cost. Last but not least, he dresses modestly, and he is modest. He only watches himself on television 4 times a week. Bob Barker.
That's great. Bob and Wendell try to stay away from water as much as possible. the culprits in that previous scene, sequence that you saw, is the engineer. He's an Irishman. Irish Oshiro.
Bob, every time the film breaks or when you're running late, you blame the equipment. You know, so the engineering department checked into these problems, and they found out that, you know, you use masking tape to splice films. And sometimes you use scotch tape, and that's not too bad because it's transparent. Another time, you know, they had a horrendous sound come up from the projector, and we found out you're using staples. You know, the thing went through the magnetic track. At least I'm glad to see you using glue. It's kind of cheap, but, you know, it's still glue, you know. And concerning videotapes, I don't know how many times I tell you, you can't recondition old videotape with dropouts by putting new coat of black paint on it. And besides that, I don't know how you can get 8-track of audio by dividing old 2-inch videotape into 1/4-inch sections. Aloha.
Bob, your director, Monty Hickok, wanted to get in this too, but he's too busy directing the show. How about let's look in on him on some tape over there, okay?
Fade it to black.
Hi, Monty.
That is good. That's a tape.
Monty, is this show? Okay, can I talk to you?
Yeah, hi, John.
Hi.
How are you?
Wanted to find out some information. What do you do as director for Pahana Years?
Well, for director as Pahana Years, I'm in charge of coordinating all of the production elements of the show.
Do you have to involve yourself with what's going on in the actual event you're filming?
Yeah, you have to be constantly involved with what's going on, yeah. Especially when you're out filming. You're constantly thinking as a director. You know, you're in charge of the total project. You have all these people working under you that do what you might call the menial task. I mean, they're actually doing the mechanics. Setting the microphones, getting the levels, checking the film cameras, seeing that everything is laid out properly. The director is there in an aesthetic role. He's overseeing the total production.
You have to think visually and...
Yeah, you think very visually, especially on location. You don't have too much time to do much else than think visually. Yeah, it's an interesting project.
How long have you been with the show?
I've been with Pahana now off and on for about 3 years.
3 years.
Yeah.
Hey, Monty, I think we seem to be having some problems with the mics in the studio. Could you give us a hand?
Oh, mic problems again. You'll have to excuse me, John.
Okay, thank you. Okay. Thank you, Monty.
Well, we'd better pray that Bob will be able to sit through the rest of this. That's your cue, Father. Chaplain P.J. Waite of Pearl Harbor.
Your show has intrigued me since my Navy transfer here from California. I've watched your techniques and with the senior citizens religiously. Now, for the past 22 months, I've been trying to capture this method of yours and for my own use with Navy seniors, especially on my mission in a nearby island. Obviously, with my relief priest ordered in and no orders yet in hand for me. You're a lousy teacher. Or else I've been watching the wrong show. So maybe, Bob, we can make a deal. You help me capture my senior audience with this new technique, and I'll pray for your show. Deal?
Someone who's... praying to see the good side of Bob is program specialist and for education television, Lucille Wong.
Everybody thinks Bob's a perfect gentleman, but he's not. He's really a grouch. I ought to know. I worked with Bob for many, many years, and he's never said a pleasant word. Why, just the other day, I was in a restaurant having breakfast, and who should walk in but Bob Bakker? He sat down and ordered 2 eggs, one scrambled and one fried. 10 minutes later, the very efficient and pleasant waitress put his order down, one fried egg and one scrambled egg. Bob, looked at the eggs, and he glared at the waitress. She said, "Is anything wrong, sir?" "Yeah," he growled. "You scrambled the wrong egg."
Oscar.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey.
Nice up here, isn't it? I nearly fell.
How do you like Hawaii?
How do I like Hawaii? Well, look, I like junky, messy places. I hate this place. Okay. It's beautiful.
Have you heard of Palhani Years?
Oh, Palhani Years?
Yeah.
That television show?
Right.
That Bob Barker television show?
Right.
That one I watched there? I like that show.
You like it?
I love it.
You don't love anything?
Oh, I love that show.
Why?
Well, you know I love trash.
Oh. Well, let's still kind of tame because our next guest comes from the Honolulu Star Bulletin. And you can imagine if he doesn't say something good about you, he'll write it. I'm glad I never had a tango with this guy, Pierre Bowman.
Bob, Charlotte Simmons and I are friends, or at least I figure we are. We made chili dogs together at Hot Dog Annie's apartment once, and if that doesn't make you friends, I don't know what does. But Charlotte said, would you be on a roast? I said, a roast? You sure it's not going to be a luau? A roast. For Bob Barker? Well, you don't refuse, Charlotte. First, you're friends. You've made chili dogs together, my God. So I said, Bob Barker, Charlotte Simmons. I figure Charlotte's Huck Finn's sister, and I figure she wants me to say nasty things about you. So I said, yeah, Charlotte, I'll do it. But Bob Barker, is he Ma Barker's son? Is he the guy who used to play Tarzan? Nah, I know who Bob Barker is. I saw you picking puka shells once on Makaha Beach on TV. Well, it was better than Salmon X. 1,000 shows, I hope you're getting paid.
You know, Pierre only came because he made a promise to Charlotte, like he said. But now she wishes he didn't come to keep it. And speaking of Charlotte, she's one of the hottest people in town to pin down. Or keep down. Pin down, yeah.
We're here in the office, the governor of the state of Hawaii, the Honorable George R. Ariyoshi. We're waiting for... Excuse me, the governor's on the telephone.
Hello? Yes, this is the governor. Oh, Bob Barker. Yes, Bob. What can I do for you? No, Bob, I'm not elderly enough, but I'm doing my best to grow old gracefully. Yes, I'll be very happy to appear on your Paohana show. How long have you been producing Paohana Years, Bob? 1,000 shows? That's unbelievable. You mean to say that Paohana show has been on KHET for 1,000 times? My goodness. How many people have been involved in your show, Bob? All senior citizens. All good, solid citizens too, huh? And you estimate your audience to be about 50,000? Bob, what's your biggest problem? I'm sure you must have some problems. How can I help you? Money? That much? Why, Bob, the state doesn't have that kind of dollars. Yeah, we've already supported you for 1,000 shows. Okay, Bob. We'll give you another, we'll find the money for another 1,000 Paohana Years show. Okay, bye-bye. Wow, Bob Walker wants another 1,000 Paohana Years show. And it looked like his hana is never going to be pow.
Well, Governor, I'm kind of sorry you took on a big one that time because Bob is going to be waiting for the money now. Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to introduce the associate, but that wild turkey hasn't gone down a little bit, right? The associate producer and director of Paohana Years,
the people behind the roast, Charlotte Simmons and Monty Hickok.
Sterling, the envelope, please.
Oh, yeah.
The Golden Turkey Award.
Who won that this time?
I don't know.
A lot of
anticipation. You'd like to read it? Yeah.
Okay.
A lot of excellent shows this year, sure.
And the winner for television's Golden Turkey Award is the Powhatan Years Show. Hey.
And accepting the award for the show is the host producer, Bob Barker.
Come on up, speak. Come on, Bob. Come on up.
Bob, before you say anything, please watch the monitors, please.
We did have fun doing it.
See you later.
You're leaving me here?
We're leaving you, Bob. Gotta get back to work.
Here's been more surprised in my whole life than when I walked in this studio a little while ago and saw this layout and all of you people. And I don't know what to say. I didn't come prepared with a script like everybody else, so I'm at a loss to respond to a roast. I do want to say that this experience with Powhatan Years for the past 1,000 programs and almost 10 years now has been the most satisfactory experience in my 40 years of broadcasting. I have gotten more satisfaction and more real intense pleasure out of these programs and preparing them and working with the people that I've worked with. Now, as the result of seeing this morning, I understand why everybody around this station has been goofing off for the past few weeks. I haven't been able to find anybody because they've been out doing things like this, I guess, preparing. It's been an emotional experience for me this morning, as you can understand. And I just want to thank everyone, Charlotte, Monty, and everybody that I've been associated with, and all you people that I've been associated with in the program. It's wonderful, and thank you all very much.